In the previous video, we started our discussion of plasma-enhanced chemical vapor deposition. We defined the floating potential and the DC offset. We will now continue the plasma-enhanced chemical vapor deposition discussion with the potential in a plasma. We introduce this x-axis denoting the position in the plasma ranging from the grounded electrode on the left to the powered electrode on the right. The y-axis denotes the potential in volts at each position. Since the powered electrode is connected to an AC voltage source, the potential in the plasma will not be constant over time. At t is 0 and at a phase shift of pi and 2 pi, the external voltage source applies no voltage, so the voltage observed at the surface of the electrode is equal to the DC offset. As we can see, the potential at the grounded electrode is 0 volts. This remains true regardless of the potential of the powered electrode. The potential increases over the sheet region to the plasma potential. As explained, the plasma has a positive potential with respect to the electrode because of the electron drain from the plasma. The potential at the powered electrode is equal to that of the grounded electrode minus the DC offset. At a phase shift of 1.5 pi, the potential at the powered electrode reaches a minimum and a large voltage drop occurs over the sheet region at the powered electrode. This leads to increased ionic bombardment at the powered electrode and, as a consequence, the plasma potential is no longer positive with respect to the grounded electrode. Without a potential difference to repel electrons, the grounded electrode will once again be primarily bombarded by electrons. At a phase shift of 0.5 pi, the potential at the powered electrode is maximal and there is no potential difference between the plasma and the powered electrode. There is now, however, a large voltage drop across the sheet region of the grounded electrode. The grounded electrode will therefore experience an increased ion bombardment. The substrate, which is located at the grounded electrode, will therefore experience a cycle of ion bombardments and electron bombardments depending on the applied external voltage. Let's look at these relations in some more detail. This graph shows the current voltage curve at the powered electrode. At the floating potential, the net current is 0, so the electron flux and the ion flux are at equal magnitude. When the voltage at the electrode is below the floating potential, the electrode experiences a current of ions. At a voltage above the floating potential, the electrode experiences an electron current. This figure shows the voltage at the surface of the electrode during the AC cycle. In this example, the AC voltage is below 0 due to the DC offset. If we relate this AC voltage to our current voltage curve, we can see that the voltage is below the floating potential for most of the time. For only a small amount of time, does the AC voltage exceed the floating voltage. This means that electrode will experience a bombardment by ions during the bulk of the AC cycle. Only for a small amount of time during each cycle does the electrode experience an electron bombardment. Importantly though, due to the high electron mobility, during this small amount of time the electron current balances the ion current in the cycle. Consequently, over the entire cycle, there is no net current flow towards the electrode and no charge accumulates on the electrode surface. The grounded electrode, at which the substrate is generally located, undergoes the same cycles of ion and electron bombardment, only at a 1 pi phase shift with respect to the powered electrode. The adsorption of ions impacting onto the surface of the substrate leads to the growth of a thin film. The ions are not the only species responsible for film growth. The reactive radicals that are created in the plasma zone, but are neutrally charged, can diffuse to the electrodes where they stick and contribute to the film growth. The momentum with which the ions impact on the substrate influence the structure, density, and even the stability of the grown material. For the moment, we assume that the transit time of an ion through the plasma sheet is significantly smaller than the typical time of one AC cycle. The momentum of the ions varies during the AC cycle. When the potential at the powered electrode is just below the floating potential, the potential difference across the plasma sheet is relatively small and the ions only gain a small amount of momentum. When the potential at the electrode surface is lowest, so the potential difference across the plasma sheet is the greatest, the ions entering the plasma sheet experience a very strong acceleration. The current over time curve can therefore also be interpreted as an energy distribution for the ions impacting on the electrode substrate surface. During the point of the lowest potential in the cycle, the ions impact on the substrate surface with a high velocity. The impact of these high velocity ions can damage the surface of the film, leading to defects in the grown material. As such, for the growth of a dense and stable film, the velocity of the ions needs to be moderated. One way of tuning the ion energy is to decrease the potential difference across the plasma sheet by adjusting the RF power. Another approach to decrease the energy of ion bombardment is by increasing the pressure during deposition. Increasing the pressure, which basically means pumping more gas particles in the same volume, leads to an increased number of ion neutral collisions. During each collision, the ion loses some of its energy and momentum, thereby decreasing its velocity. Another parameter that can be tuned is the RF frequency. The frequency can be increased to such a level that the transit time of the ion through the plasma sheet is in the same order of the AC cycle time. This means that ions do not have the time to gain the full energy that maximum voltage bias could deliver. In other words, at very high frequencies, the ions that experience the maximum potential difference across the plasma sheet do not have enough time to cross the plasma sheet. This consequently leads to lower ion bombardment energies. However, the RF power, deposition pressure, and RF frequency do not only affect the ion impact energy, but also the deposition rate and the composition and structure of the material. Other deposition conditions, like the flow rates of the supplied gases and the substrate temperature, also strongly affect the material properties of the grown film. Time to recap. This video has been a brief introduction into the plasma physics essential to plasma enhanced chemical vapor deposition. We discussed that due to the much higher electromobility with respect to the ions in a plasma, any electrically isolated body introduced in a plasma will obtain a negative charge with respect to the plasma. This negative charge is known as the floating potential. The potential difference occurs over a small region adjacent to the surface of the object, known as the plasma sheet. We also saw that due to the fast-switching powered electrode, the electrode surface will obtain a permanent negative DC charge that affects the potential across the plasma. Due to this DC offset, a substrate placed at one of the electrodes will experience an ion flow during most of the AC cycle. The impact of ions onto the substrate leads to the growth of a thin film. Finally, we discussed that the composition and structure of the grown film depend strongly on the deposition conditions. In the next two videos, we will discuss the other deposition techniques used for the various thin film PV technologies.